Okay, what we're going to do today is get your Automatic 1111 working on a local install on a MacBook Air M1 using Ventura operating system. Up here is basically the setup for how to do it. Part of that is just using the GitHub repository. They have a lot of direct information for it, but I broke it down into these steps, which of course is also on that page. And we'll pull their GitHub up. And this is essentially the same setup, but there's a few caveats, things that we might have to fix. So the first thing, you have to install Homebrew. I've already installed some of these things, but just wanted to let you know, you click that first link, and this is Homebrew. And essentially you have this line of text. Don't be intimidated by this. This is all part of using the terminal. And all you're going to do is click on the clipboard here, and what that does is it's going to copy that line of code. When I do command spacebar, it pulls up my search, and what I'm going to do is put in terminal, and I'm going to have it open my terminal. Now that it's open, you can see the cursor is already set to that particular end of line, and what I'm going to do is just paste what I copied from Homebrew repository. And then I click return. It's going to ask for your password. It's going to tell you that it's going to install all of these things. Now, it's going to take a while to install them, and sometimes it might seem like it's going to hang, but sit there and wait, and you'll get to the end of it. Right here, it's telling you what it's going to do, and then you basically press return or enter and have it do it. Now, mine's already done, and so what it's going to do is basically just check to see that it is done. It may take longer for yours, but be patient with it. Then you have to do the next steps. The next step is, this is what will actually come up. So I copied that just to make sure it's there. There's a few more things that'll be there, but it'll say, run these two commands in your terminal to add Homebrew to your path. Now your path is your location on your hard drive. And so here I've created a dummy system. What you're gonna do is you're gonna look over in your side panel for your home drive. If you don't have that, what you're gonna do is go up to your Finder, make sure the Finder is the application that is running, go Settings, and then you're going to run down your list here to make sure that you have your home folder in there, which is going to be, in this particular case, I created a fake one. It's called TestM. So that you're going to see appear on the side here. So if that's off, it won't be there. If it's on, it will be there. When you click on that, what that does is it's going to give you the information. Essentially, your Automatic 111 folder will be entered in here. So essentially, when you click on the TestM or whatever the name of your folder is going to be called, you might have named your system Sally's system or Sally's computer, or you may have just left it as hard drive, HD, or something like that. That will be listed here. You'll click on that, and that will give you the home folder. And in this home folder is where you're going to see Automatic 1111 after this install. So we want to make sure that we run these two commands in the terminal. You basically select from this point to here, and then you'll hit your second mouse button for a copy if you want, or just Command C. You go back into your terminal. It's already set up. That's where the cursor is. Command V for paste, and what that's going to do is it's going to run a short little command to make sure that your pathway is set up. Now, mine's already done, so I don't have to do that, but you'll enter that in, paste it, and the next step. So after you've done this, you'll open a new terminal window and run brew install cmake, etc. Right after run, you're going to select this. That's what you're going to copy. Copy, pull up my terminal again. I'm going to hit Command N to pull up a new terminal. Hit paste, and I've already done this. So you're going to paste this, and then you're going to hit return, and it's going to take a long time, and it's going to run and install quite a bit of stuff. And this will be filled, and it'll keep going for quite a while. I have another video here that I did earlier that shows you exactly what happens. When that's done, then you will go to the third position, which again here it says by running git clone automatic stable. We're going to do right click on that, copy that, and I'm going to paste, hit return, and what it's doing is it quickly installs Stable Diffusion web UI in your home folder. Now, this is where all your magic is going to happen. In order for this to work, clearly you need some models. So it's telling you exactly where you want to put these checkpoints. Now, the checkpoints can be a .ckpt file or a safetensor file. And those you can get from Civitai, civitai.com, as well as many other places. The .safetensor files are safer. It's harder to inject any malware into that, and that's why people find favor using those. If you trust the source, the .ckpt files are okay too. It tells you exactly where you want to put the files. So essentially, when I go through my folder, I'll double-click on the Stable Diffusion Web UI folder and get rid of my side panel here. And you will see a models folder. Double-click on that, and you'll see Stable Diffusion. And here it tells you, put your Stable Diffusion checkpoints in here. I just happen to have one set up, the Liberty checkpoint. I just drop that in for my downloads. Then I can go back if I want. And then it tells you exactly how to run this. Now, there are a couple of things that you may encounter as a problem, meaning sometimes you may have a thing where it says, can't run Git. If you can't run Git, what you do is you go to the App Store and you can simply download Xcode, which is free from Apple. That's a long install, takes a while, but once you download that, it'll install the proper items so that you can use Git repositories and so forth. If you don't have that problem, it shouldn't be a problem. Next command here is cd stable diffusion web UI. So I'm going to copy that. And I'm demonstrating copy. Normally I just do command C. Go into my terminal and I'm going to paste that, command V. And what this does is it changes the directory. So CD is change directory so that anything that I start typing into here affects files and executables and so forth within that particular directory. So after the change directory, then we're going to go this here, which is, we'll copy that. Essentially what we're doing is we're running a script, and this is the script. So it's a shell, basically. So shell script webui.sh. That code, it runs that, it executes it. Now, there may be problems with this. If this isn't working and automatic 1111 comes up, but then it produces some errors, then what you'll do is you'll use this code instead. But if running this, like I hit that, what that's going to do is it's going to start the program itself. And it's going to install some files because it needs to have some of those running. And again, some of this takes time, so please be patient. So now what's happened is, at the end here, it says running on local URL. So right now, it's really cool because you just copy that. And then you're going to pull up Safari or Chrome. I tend to use Chrome when I use Automatic 1111, just because it seems more stable. So if I produce another window with Command N and then Command V to paste in that, it's going to run this with the model already put into here. If you add more models, meaning going in through here into your models, then you go down, you can see all the other things that it downloaded, and then you go to Stable Diffusion. If you add a bunch more models in here, what happens is it all shows up here. And if they don't show up, you just hit this for refresh and they'll show up there. And then you can switch between the different models. Now here, time over the mountain makes completely no sense. Doesn't matter. I'm going to run a couple of the things if you aren't familiar with Automatic 1111. This one, the ++2m Keras or the DDIM will produce a more realistic result. Always hit restore faces. Can leave everything right now as is. We're going to try to run this. Now, this is what you may encounter. Python quit unexpectedly. So we're going to just ignore that. I'm going to go back because I need to run it with this code, the ./ web UI .sh spacebar, there's a space here, -/no -half. Okay. going to copy that. And that's going to be the one that runs your code every time. So we're going to paste that in here, hit return. And if you need to, if something's not showing up in here again, you just hit Command N, run a new terminal. Make sure that you CD into it, CD Stable Diffusion folder, so you get back into it. And now I put in the new code with the no half. You can see that's listed in here as well. This should be the same code or the same URL address. Okay, so hitting refresh should make that work well for you. I'm going to just run a little test here. Let's see, person standing with watch. Okay, liberty, everything else good. Doesn't really matter. There are several, like we said, things that DDIM and the 2M Keras work well. And just going to run this and let it operate. Again, this web user interface is just a front end for what's happening in the background in your terminal. And this is real time, so we're running it. Letting you see what that occurs. This is a MacBook Air M1 chip. The M2 chip is going to be faster. Clearly, I've actually run comparisons on different things. The M2 chip does work faster. I've got an iPad Pro M2, and I use a program called DrawThings, which I'll do a video on that as well, a detailed breakdown on that. And the speed is different. It is definitely faster on an M2. But this isn't slow for what you get. You get full automatic 1111. And there we go. That's the image. Makes no sense, but there it is. So I hope that helped you. If you have any questions, please put it in the comments below, and please feel free to thumbs up so it can help share to other Mac users out there who are having difficulty with this. Just make sure that you use that extra web UI here, the no half, if you're having problems there. Any other problems, just let me know, and I'll do my best to either create it in another video or just respond in the comments. And if you have an inkling, subscribe. Thank you. We'll be right back.